Next news is out of British Columbia. Atheist nurses' fight against mandatory AA will go before BC Human Rights Tribunal. Byron Wood, a BC nurse who lost his job when he refused to attend a 12-step program for addiction, will get a chance to argue he was discriminated against as an atheist. He contends Alcoholics Anonymous's emphasis on placing your life in the hands of a higher power simply won't work for someone who doesn't hold any religious beliefs. That's an argument worth considering, according to the BC Human Rights Tribunal. Yeah. On Wednesday, it denied Vancouver Coastal Health's application to dismiss Wood's complaint alleging discrimination on the basis of religion. In its submissions to the tribunal, Vancouver Coastal Health argued that the treatment plan designed for Wood was reasonable and supported by medical experts.
Wow, this is great. This atheists are fighting for their rights, right? This is, by the way, my backyard. This is BC.
Yeah.
This is British Columbia. Yeah, this is where I am.
This is awesome because even in America, you and I, we just reported on this recently. You know, our judges here can say, you have to learn about this religion. You have to go to religious counseling. You have to do this. We can do that here. But in BC, they're saying that Alcoholics Anonymous may actually be violating the rights of this atheist in the fact that one of its steps is to place your hands in a higher power. Now, a lot of people can argue about this. I researched into this too. That not every anonymous association forces you to place your hands in a higher power, such as a god. But they do have you do a substitute if you're an atheist, such as your mother, your father, your wife, your children. Make them your higher power, and then it's all okay. So a lot of people are saying that. However, court-ordered Alcoholics Anonymous means that somebody who's going to be overseeing this may not accept that he's completed that step if he hasn't actually given his life in the hands of a higher power, meaning a god. So this isn't a ridiculous complaint in the fact that he could just say he did it. He doesn't want to have to say that he's giving his life over to God. And I don't blame him for that.
First, we got a super chat, $2 super chat from Labman27. He or she is saying, keep up the good work, you guys. Oh, thank you. But I want to say actually something. I'm actually very encouraged by this news, but also a little bit disappointed. I'm encouraged because it's amazing that we have actually courts now in the world where they're like, yeah, you're discriminating against atheists, right? I mean, that's amazing, right? Government courts are saying like, yeah, this is bullshit. You're discriminating against atheists, you know, human rights tribunals, like this will set like global, you know, examples for other courts around the world, which is amazing. Like if other places could be like, oh, look, the BC human rights tribunal did something like this, maybe we could, you know, it sets a precedent, right? It sets a model for other people to follow, which is awesome. I'm also very disappointed that this even needed, like, this is British Columbia. It's supposed to be one of the most secular places on the planet, right? So the fact that a nurse lost their job because they didn't want to put their hands, you know, put their life in the hands of a higher power. Like, you could lose your job for that in British freaking Columbia? Like, really? Like, that's, you know, I mean, it's progress, but it's progress that I didn't know was needed in British Columbia. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, this is a very, very, very secular country, Canada, and British Columbia, I mean, at least Vancouver is very secular. So, but I'm glad that it was needed because I want a human rights tribunal to say, like, go on record and say that you can't discriminate against atheists, you know? So for us to have that somewhere, making that statement somewhere, and a government court, that is a huge win on our side. And I know it seems like, so look how far behind we are that we need that. Like we have so many people going to prison or being arrested or losing their job or being fined for discriminating against Hindus, Muslims, Christians, Jews. But we see it as a huge win for some court somewhere in the world to just mention atheists, like just like just give us anything. Like, thank you, oh, thank you, judge, for noticing that we atheists also exist. Like,
yes, this, right?
This is how far behind we are when it comes to atheists. But we take it. We'll take it. Thank you. We'll take it. Let me see what the top comment is. The top comment is by Garething. AA is said to be non-religious system that mentions God 12 times in the preamble. Go figure. Yeah, they're religious because they constantly mention higher power and God and all of that, surrender to a higher power, bullshit stuff. And they're like, oh, we're non-religious. Bullshit.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.